Everything's coated. It's been snowing regularly for the past couple days, but just lightly. And it started to pick up tonight quite a bit. Oh, she's covered. It's covered in snow. Wow. Okay. Good thing we came out.
Hey folks, how are you? Joe here. It's just after supper time. We haven't camped out here in about a week. I've come here periodically through the week to knock the snow off of this thing. And we're gonna camp out tonight. It started coming down really heavy after supper, so Wolf and I jumped in the car and headed on over. We'll spend tonight here and tomorrow here and hang out and do some camp chores and crafts and stuff. But right now, it's not good to let this snow sit on here, so let's get it off.
Hey, buddy. My headlights on over there on my four-wheeler, illuminating everything. Alright. That's a pretty decent accumulation of snow down there.
Last time when I came here to check on it, I opened it up and it was soaking wet inside. We've had pretty calm temperatures for, pretty tame temperatures for winter, and it's been melting and freezing, and inside was, everything was just soaked.
No fleas today.
If I was a backpacker, that would be my name. That'd be my trail name, Snow Flea. I thought about that the other day when I was editing that video. Snow Flea. Holy accumulations. People from Nortent contacted me and were like, oh, it's great to see. You're gonna leave it out there, Joe, but you can't. Let the snow accumulate on it. I said, I know. I know. It's frozen shut. Oh, you're just going right on in, eh, bud? Right in on. Oh yeah, that's what I like to see.
There's some real light. There we go. Yeah, we got some real light going on now. So check it out, how it looks out here. You know, this is white winter wonderland, right? But then you go inside. And look, it's dry. It's dry and there's no snow. And I love that. And I absolutely love that. Look at that, so much light. So much light, we're doing good, boys and girls.
Want everything to dry out. Oh yeah, no, this is, look at that. That would have all been water a couple degrees ago. So, first things first is fire. I stored a bunch of stuff in here last time, so. They'll be able to get it going pretty easily. I love the old wood storage. See how much the top of that is smoking out? Not great. It might just be water. It is just water. Oh, okay. Oh, the whole thing's full of water. There's a little divot in here. Come on now. It doesn't want to move usually until it gets pretty warm. There we go. Anyways, it's all good. I got the thing open. It needs to all steam out and smoke out as much as it has to, and then I'll close it up tonight before bed, but. should be pretty good now.
What'd you find there, buddy? Bones of camps past. I'm sure you can see all this frost on top here, right?
So that's all turning into liquid now on the inside, and hopefully it'll all dry up relatively easily. Oh boy, it's all over my lens. So we're gonna get this rocking, dry up everything as good as possible, then we'll open up our sleeping quarters just so it all stays hunky-dory, you know? Hunky-dory. I don't know how much longer I'll leave this thing set up for. It's been about a month now. But we're looking into a lot of snow this coming up week, so I'll probably leave it up for that for sure. Hey, let's get rid of this. I've wanted to get rid of this thing since I put this here. So, you see this? Right here, it's a knot or something. It's a root. I keep stepping on it. It's actually wore a hole right through the mat there, no joke. All right. Well, can't have that. Just do a little smashy smashy. Oh, I wish I had my little freaking bush tool out here. Okay, we'll leave that there. We'll bring the woodsman's pal back out. And we'll get it out with that, but it's already better than it was, but we'll be able to remove that root completely. Nice. Hey, buddy. I bet you it would be more efficient to shut the door and do it. We will do that in a little bit. I'm trying to get everything aired out. Do that. Oh, yeah, but geez, a wet one. That's the thing, though. It's been up for a long time. It's fluctuated temps quite a bit. But all in all, it's an easy fix, you know what I mean? Crank the heat, and it'll all dry up eventually. And again, I'm super happy to have my sleeping area like completely blocked off from all this. Holy smokes, bud!
My dog doesn't like me. He's gone doing his own thing.
All right, I think we're all golden now. I think we're home free on the moisture front. Looks all dry to me. Let's give it the old bang test. No. No moisture droplets. If so, only a few. So we're gonna open up our princess bed. And see how comfy it is in there. If it's dry or wet, too. Gotta see that.
Nope, I can't lie. The mummy part of the head part of the mummy bag, was pushed up against the side, and it is frozen / soaked. So that will take some drying out, but that's okay. I am pretty happy overall. Get this out of the way, and start drying out our sleeping stuff. There's no rush. I'm gonna make some popcorn. Probably go to bed a bit early, but we still got plenty of time.
Look at this. Just like in my last video, I was talking about my puffy jacket, but I don't really care if I wear it too hard and poke a hole in it. Same thing with my sleeping bag. Oh, piss. You know, you're out and about all the time, and that tenacious tape goes a long way, though. Anyway, I'm feeling here. Feels like the whole top part of my sleeping bag might be a little damp. So anyways, with this opened up, oh yeah, I can feel the ice on the inside of this thing.
Not much, just again where it was touching the edge, but we'll get this fire cranking even more so and dry all my stuff out. It's -4 right now. It's supposed to get down to -6 tonight. And this is a -10 bag. Plus I have the fire. So everything's fine. Yeah. Actually the foot box is a little wet too, surprise, surprise, but overall no worse for wear.
Oh yeah. It's snowing a bit. Hey? A little bit more than it was a couple minutes ago. That's for sure.
No snow? Snow. No snow? Snow. That's crazy. Barely any snow. Tons of snow.
Pop! One, two, three, right up.
Ah!
Okay.
Oh boy.
Real deal popcorn right there.
Nice.
Nothing better than wet popcorn, you know? I know it sounds weird, but I love it. It's freaking good. Not necessarily the wet part. The spice, the taste, the flavor, you know? A little bit more in there, all good. No, Wolfie, not for you, buddy. You got a lot of stuff already. All the time. Okay, I'll give you one. Good boy. It's hot. You like that? Nope, you spit it right out. Mmm. Mmm. Very, very tasty. Nice. Well, I'm gonna enjoy this. Keep stacking wood in there. And try and dry this piece out even more. Dry my sleeping stuff now. Out now.
Stay, Wolf. Wait there, buddy. Boy.
Closing it down for the night. Shutting up shop. Time to make this place comfortable. My blanket. Where I can step on in the night if I need to. Take the boots off, you know what I mean? Walk around without fear of snowiness. Fear of snowiness. Real syndrome. Oh yeah. It's heating up in here quite a bit. Okay. Feeling nice and cozy. Nice and comfy. Nice. Got some hardwood in there. Should be pretty self-sustaining for a while. Okay. That's pretty safe, and that will certainly dry, and now my coat's got to dry as well. So that's fun. I'll put that up over here. Woo! She's toasty. Super toasty. Okay. That's gonna dry out in a second.
That's about it, eh, bud? Well, I don't know if you can tell, but I am actually sweating. Like, for real sweating. It's very warm. It's almost 11 o'clock at night, so I want to go to bed. We'll get up in the morning, have a good breakfast, and spend the day out here doing skills and chores and just camp stuff. So you guys have a good night, and I'll see you in the morning.
Morning, bud.
Morning. Let's get out there and see how it looks.
want some breakfast. Give me a little bit of food before we go. Oh, the big boy.
Quite a bit of bacon grease in here from last night. I'll just throw his food in there and let him eat it out.
Sit.
Wolfie, sit. Good boy. You wait.
No. Okay, free.
Good boy. I poured a bunch of the grease in this egg carton cardboard that I had. I got a couple eggs here as well. So with any luck, we'll be able to use that for a fire starter this morning. Oh, before we go, let me show you my cool little gadget. So check it out. This is a hot water on demand right here. It's got a spout. It sits on or near the stove, and you put snow or water in there, and it just boils as you go. So here's the thing. It's got this rounded spot to it where I'm sure it could sit there. Actually, that's not a bad spot for it. It doesn't really take up any room at all. I could still cook and everything. Because I was going to say, it could go there, or I could really go back here too, but I'm going to put this, let's see, that over there. Nope, it doesn't. I thought it would lock it in. Okay. Well, now we know. It will just go right here. And this must just be for a handle. But yeah, I know, it kind of sits, oh, it sits there perfectly, actually. It's got, that's exactly how it's supposed to go. Okay, let's fill this thing up. And, well, I guess we gotta get a fire going and everything too, but yeah.
Seems to be working okay. I don't put any wood on it yet, just the carton. With the bacon grease. Yeah, it worked. Wow, I'd say it worked. Wolfie's like, I could have eaten that. I could eat that. Waster.
Seeing as how this is the first time I'm using this, I kind of want to clean it out first. So maybe just a boil, and then I'll dump it out and then use it. I got some water here collected from the creek. This holds a liter and a half or so in this pot. And that's only almost just over half full. This might hold 2.5 or 3 liters in here, roughly at least. We'll set that back. Nice and snug. There we go. Stay there. Wolfie, get up. Okay, no, that's my food, buddy. Back up. Okay, so anyways, yeah, we'll see how that works. That's on. Look at that. Pretty slick, man. Moving on up in the world, eh, buddy? Holy smokes. All right, let's check on this water. I'm about ready to go. I've got a day bag packed and everything.
Getting there. All right, it's boiling now. Quite a bit. No, she fogged it up, but she's boiling, you can see. So I'm gonna dump that out.
and refill it, and then we'll go.
Oh yeah. Hot water, anyone? Look at that, hot water on demand at the frickin' semi-permanent winter camp.
As long as I can use running water, I will. That's the only reason that this water's still open is because it's flowing quite a bit.
There. All right, cool. We're good to go.
I'm loving this spot. Hey buddy, so home-like, so comfy. Getting old and soft. Careful, that's a hot stove there, buddy.
Pretty nice, a little silicone on the handle too. Not too shabby. Let her steep there. We'll get our breakfast on.
You know, did we tire you out a little bit there, buddy? Hey, how'd you do? Hey, how'd you do? How'd you do? Is that a good boy? Oh yeah.
Oh, sorry, buddy. You okay?
Some more wood on there, and then we'll start cooking.
Some nice maple.
Doesn't he look all worried?
I'm not gonna get any food. No water.
Dude. Can't blame that on the throw. Here, ready? Oh, there you go.
Hungry.
Oh, he says, excuse me.
All right, here's how it looks.
Scrambled up the eggs and the grease and the remnants. I think I want to mix them all together. Mix everything together and cook it up a little touch more. Try and crisp it all. And then dig in. This would be a nice... Is this a skillet? Would this be called a skillet? Oh, if I had some peppers, why didn't I bring peppers? Bro, peppers will go amazing in this. Oh, could he smoke? Joey dropping the pepper. Anyways. Be very good. I don't have any seasoning in it, but the bacon
and the cast iron has plenty of flavor already. Not to mention the garlic and onions. And, yeah, nothing to sneeze at here, folks. Some cheese, too. Okay, peppers and cheese next time. All of this plus peppers and cheese. I wouldn't even mind jalapeno peppers. That would be very tasty. Okay.
Oh, man, I'm excited. I am excited to eat this. Delicious. A little bit of everything on that one. Oh. Oh boy. Yeah, that's really good. Yeah. Wow. Oh, it all works so good. Having a good time. I want to see if I can build a buck saw out here because I have an extra blade. And it's a good lesson and test for me too. I haven't done it in years. So we'll after we're done this, we'll go do that. And, oh, we gotta go get that big piece of firewood. Good boy. Oh, man. Oh, the little bits of garlic, little pockets of surprise. Pockets of flavor. Okay, well, that was really, really good food, and I feel content. How about you? How about you, big boy? I've gathered a few pieces of what I need already to save some time. This is how to build a saw in the bush with just using your pocket knife or your belt knife and a saw blade. You don't have to have these rings on them, but it helps. If not, you're gonna have to carve little pegs or do something else to keep it in place. But here's the gist of it. I've collected wood and saw them with the saw blade. Enough to make my handles, at least, for the buck saw. So I cut these, right? And then I made notches in the middle, right where my fingers are. And that's where the middle piece is going to go. And that's what I have to do now. So I'm going to show you the process of doing this. So I'm going to measure it, what I need. Right about there, I think. We're gonna cut it using just the saw blade, which sometimes can be painstakingly long. The point of this is to just be able to be more sufficient, self-sufficient in the bush and use what you have, carry less type thing, the whole more you know, less you carry. More Skahansky vibe. But with these days, honestly, bag was saw, man. Or silky, you can't really, they're not much more weight than this thing. And they work awesome. But we're getting through it anyway. We're almost there. And we'll trim up all the ends with my knife, like I already did on these ones. There we go. Okay. Hopefully that's the right size. You want the notch
on the inside, and you put the wood on the inside of the ring, butt it up to it as tight as you can, and that ring is going to hold it in place from slipping farther out. Okay, see what I mean? Now, the middle part is for tension, as well as the top. You're gonna put a rope for tension, but the middle part, I guess, is just for like bracing more than anything, for strength. So this has gotta get carved and go in there. I put them a little low. I should have put the notches a bit higher, but anyways, this is what it is. So we're gonna have to notch this out now. You wanna keep it, I wanna make sure that I notch evenly on both sides too, so it's lined up properly. Wolfie's gone. Oh, Wolfie boy. Okay, it's gotta come taper in at the end instead of being flat. Okay, that'll work. Now I gotta do the same to here. I really wanna make sure it's lined up properly. That's my biggest thing right now. Okay, so if I, oh, the sun's coming out. Cut right there. That's wild, the sun, haven't seen that in a couple days. It's gorgeous out here. Fresh snow on the trees, sun's shining, dogs just wherever. Life is good. So you need a piece of paracord for this as well, or other rope. Obviously paracord is the go-to. Doesn't matter if it's loose, because I can tension it with the stick after. I want to make it as tight as possible, right off the hop, so I don't have to mess around too much, but right about there. Like that. And then this goes around here, comes back to each other, and we'll just tie that off. Right about there. Yeah. Okay, so that's not gonna come undone. Nice. We got our toggle here, and if it's not long enough, we can get another one. That's fine. Yeah, it'll be long enough. Okay. So we'll just keep twisting it and twisting it and twisting it, and it's gonna tension up. It's gonna make things easier to deal with here. Oh no, did my camera fall? Anyway, as you can see, as you keep twisting it, the tension really helps hold things together, and it should cut pretty well. We'll test it out, that's for sure. Really crank it. Should be able to withstand some tension. Okay, I'm hearing cracks. So we're gonna back off one. No, we'll keep it there. Okay. I wouldn't mind having this toggle down a bit lower, to be honest. So slide it down. There we go. Tighten it back up. Okay. Yeah, she's bowing a bit. Anyways, it's a roughed out saw. We'll go We'll test it out right now. Oh yeah, there you go. There you go, straightened it out. Maybe one more tension. One more turn. Cool. I don't hate that. I don't hate that at all. All right, well, let's try to cut this. Works pretty good. That is punky though, right? So we'll, maybe we'll go get that piece of wood that we got earlier. And I think that's oak or hard maple, like I said. And we'll, oh shit, nothing? And we'll give it a test on that. I'm not gonna bring this down to buck it up. We'll leave this here and we'll bring the agua. But yeah, let's go do that. Test it out when we get back and get the firewood. You know, getting two birds stone at once type thing. Oh man, that water getter hotter thing is pretty cool.
You okay? What are you saying over there?
Look at that.
Just tons of water. Tons of water ready for the taking.
That's awesome. It's the little things, you know? It's the little things in life.
Hey, good boy. This is from where Tosh and I camped yet last year. Might as well bring this stump over to camp. The four-wheeler, which I have not done yet. Love it. That's slick. I should build a sawhorse. That's what I should do. There, perfectly good wood. And honestly, if you're making something like this anyways, you're not trying to saw through a bunch of freaking red oak anyways. Build a house, so nice, quick, easy way to build that. The rings help quite a bit. Like I said, if you didn't have the rings, you'd have to put little wooden pegs in or figure something else out, maybe wrap paracord. But the rings sometimes come up and around like this, secure it even more if the logs, if your sticks are bigger, like this diameter, I should have done. But anyways, pretty slick, pretty happy with that.
Oh, the day has changed, man. Holy crap. Man, I just got up from a much needed nap. the sun is gone completely. And look at this, the tent is sagging. It snowed quite a bit. Must have melted on top here. Clean that off. Easy enough to clean off. Make an outdoor fire, cook my steak out here tonight.
Man, this is just a constant snow. Like, it's not anything crazy, but every now and then it kicks up pretty substantial. And it's just the fact that it's constant, man. It's cool, I'm happy for it. It's been a weird year for snow. All right, that'll be my base. That's a good base. Get a bunch more wood. Spark her up. Spark. Well, the snow is really coming in. I'm gonna have to shut my tent up here pretty soon. There we go. Nothing a little blue foam pad can't fix, right, folks? What's your most important piece of gear? Blue foam pad, please. All right, well, I bucked up that wood I got and gathered over here. Ooh, sounds like a bowling pin dry. Nice, okay. This will work. Wow. It really sounds dry. Wind's kicking up. Alright, well, that wasn't so bad. Bunch of decent wood. My stove has gone out. It's been out since I took that nap. Since I woke up from the nap, rather. But this will be some good hardwood for it for tonight. I got some Brussels sprouts to cook with my steak. Probably cook those on the stove. Bowling pins, I tell you.
That looks like it's going well. Keep throwing wood on that, and by the time I'm ready to eat, it'll be golden.
And this is hardwood. Go buy them. Nothing wrong with it. And the good thing is, you can always rebuild it if you need to, relatively easily. It's not that difficult of a project at all. Actually, it's a good little practice for knife skills and minimalist type stuff. Good boy, Wolfie.
This one's bending. It's because it's live. If I were to have used dead, hard, strong wood, that wouldn't happen, but it's much harder to deal with, to work with.
Bye-bye, I'm son. Well, it's getting a little nasty out here. I think I'm gonna close her down. Little Joe's big hungry. Should cook pretty good there.
My lens got foggy when I brought it out
of the
tent there, so it's a little messed up. Anyway, steak's almost done, and hopefully I can get my focus back. Come on. Piss. Okay. Looking good, a little foggy. We got the steak in here with the Brussels sprouts. And this is gonna be a super good dinner.
Oh, all my stuff's fogged right up, boys and girls. But regardless, we got the meats. We got the meats, we got the Brussels sprouts, and we're putting them in our stomachs via our throat right now. Hopefully this fog action gets fixed on both cameras. Oh, we are getting there, folks. We're feeling a little full, but we're getting there still. Boom, 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 boom. I want you in my room. Brussels sprouts. It's hot, can you tell? I'm freaking sweating my nards off. Wolfman don't have nards. Well, I can't get my other camera to work at all. The freaking fog is all through the lens. But regardless, I'm gonna take this as a cue to just call it here. I'm very warm, as I'm sure you can see. And all we're doing tonight is just chilling out, maybe listen to a podcast, go to bed, and we're gonna get up early and go home in the morning. Got some stuff to do. It's Monday, kids gotta go to school, and it's Christmas break now. But I do have some things to do on Monday, tomorrow. Anyways, hope you guys enjoyed the video. I hope you got to see most of it without the foggy lens. And hope you guys are enjoying the series. There'll only be maybe one or two more videos in this series, just because I've already put out like four or five, and it's about time to stop doing that and do something else. But I'm having a lot of fun out here. I really enjoy having this out here, a spot to come with Wolfie, and yeah. Hopefully you guys enjoy it too. So, hope you enjoyed the video. I'll see you soon on the next one. Bye.